I was praying and the Lord opened my eyes to see this operation of this pandemic. It's operating like a dark cloud, and it's moving from place to place, covering so many places. But today, with the sound of praise and worship, we are going to destroy the operation of this pandemic. And any infirmity that is meant to bring death upon you and your family, as your threefold amen will come out, I decree now with the authority of Christ, let that agenda be frustrated in the name of Jesus. Let's worship him again. I want you to everything within your heart, let it worship him. Let everything just begin to raise that voice of worship from your home right now. Just give him adoration. There is none like him. Just worship him. Oh, he's the great I am. As we begin to glorify the name of Jesus, every dark cloud of pestilence over our land, we hover that dark cloud right now to begin to move away. Let them begin to clear away. Let them begin to clear away. Let them begin to clear away. In the name of Jesus. Oh, somebody worship this God. Oh, as the sound of worship is coming out, that cloud is clearing away from your house, from your cities, from your counties, from your states, oh, from your nation. Somebody worship this God. He's worthy of our praise. Oh, hallelujah. We worship you. Only tired of our bush. Oh Jesus, we adore your holy name. Thank you, Jesus. Aha, worship him. Glorify your name. Move it. Glorify your name. Glorify your name in all the earth. Glorify your name.
Glorify your name.
Somebody glorify Jesus' name. Glorify your name.
Glorify your name.
We glorify your name.
Glorify your name.
Oh, in our cities, in our counties, oh, in our state. Glorify your name. Glorify your name. Somebody sing it.
Glorify your name.
Somebody sing it.
Glorify your name.
Oh,
in all the earth.
Oh, let us sing it one more time.
Glorify your name.
Oh, somebody sing it. Make sure that sound is coming from your home.
Oh,
Jesus, your name is power. Jesus, your name is might. Jesus, your name will break every stronghold. Jesus, your name is Lord. Jesus, your name.
Jesus, your name is power.
Oh, oh, oh.
Jesus, your name is Lord.
Oh, Jesus.
Jesus, your name
will break every stronghold.
Jesus, your name is
Lord. Oh, lift your name. Somebody lift his name. Oh, lift your name. Oh, lift your name. Over the situation, Most High,
yes, you are the Lord.
Oh, yes, you are.
Most High,
Most High, Most High, Most High, yeah,
yes, you
are. Oh, yes, you are. To pray like this as a church, and I want us to pray from the depth of our heart. Anywhere you are, make sure you are praying. This is not the time to be doing something else or be distracted. I want you to pray. We will pray like this and make this declaration that every dark cloud of pestilence over our land, clear away in the name of Jesus. I want you to begin to say it right now. Every dark cloud of pestilence over my life, clear away, clear away, clear away, clear away, clear away, clear away, clear away. Say it well. Let those dark clouds begin to clear away. Begin to mention countries of the world. Let them clear away, clear away, clear away. Glad away, glad away, glad away, glad away, glad away, glad away. Lord, my robo, shut on over there. Oh, glad away, glad away. Every dark cloud of pestilence over our land, glad away. Let my robo shut on the edge. Oh, begin to glad away. Let the mighty dosh, let the dark cloud clear away. Let the dark cloud clear away. Let the dark cloud clear away. Somebody say it well. Let it clear away. Let it clear away. Let this dark cloud clear away. Let them clear away. Let it clear away. Let it clear away. Let it clear away. Let it clear away. Let this dark cloud clear away. Let this dark cloud clear away over the nations of the earth. Clear away. 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 In Jesus' mighty name we pray. As a church, we are going to pray for the front liners, the nurses, the doctors. Why some of us are hiding at home, sanitizing every part of our body. There are some people out there helping people that have been hurt by this pestilence. I want us to pray for them. I want us to pray that we laminate their lives with the blood of Jesus. No evil will come near you. No evil. You are not bringing coronavirus to your own children. You are not bringing to your own family. Let us open our mouth and begin to pray for them. Let us begin to intercede for them. In the name of Jesus. Oh, those in authorities that are going all around to fight this pandemic. Let us begin to laminate them with the blood of Jesus. 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 In Jesus' mighty name we pray. You will now pray this for yourself. You pray it for your family. You are going to pray loud and clear. Heavy infirmity. Walking with the hair. A sign against my life. Die. I want you to confront it. The prayer you are praying now. Some of us, we say, oh, we are at home. But we still go out to the store. We still go out to the store where a lot of people have been affected. But I pray again, as your amen will come out, any infirmity walking with the hair, a sign against your life, I order that infirmity to fall down and die. You see, when you pray this type of prayer, even when you touch something that has been infected, the power of this prayer will make that virus what? Die. Are you ready now? You will say it again. Hey! Infirmity walking with the air fashion against me, die. Open your mouth and pray. Open your mouth and pray. Open your mouth and pray. John de Kete de Babosh. Hey, Apodo Shete Yaria. Beloved, make those declarations. Make those decrees. It will not come near the dwelling place of your children. Yet de Karabosh. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. The current of the anointing of God is flowing here right now. And I want everyone hearing me now, and we have any symptom of infirmity around you, because the enemy is making sure he's fighting people now. It's infirmity, all forms. He knows you can't run to the hospital. It's filled up. But I want everybody to pray. Whether you are feeling any weakness anywhere or not, I need you to say this loud and clear. Stronghold of infirmity! Upon my life, I pull you down in the name of Jesus. Open your mouth and begin to pull it down right now. Oh, pull it down, pull it down, pull it down, pull it down, pull down that stronghold. And they can't all shit here. Hey, pull down that stronghold in the name of Jesus. You will not call 911, you are not going to any emergency room. And they paro shit here. In the padu shete ye bekadia, in madi babo shetadia. Oh yes, oh yes, oh yes, oh yes, oh yes. Pull down the stronghold of infirmity every symptom of infirmity. Hear the word of the Lord. Oh, yeah. Get out. 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 In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Little Shindekano Polyatanos. Let the healing power of the Most High God flow upon his people now. It is written concerning these ones, by the stripes of Jesus, you are healed. You are healed. Check yourself right now. You are healed. That current of healing is all over you right now, from the top of the head to the sole of the feet. From the top of the head to the sole of the feet, you are healed. Thank you, Lord Jesus. I want us to pray again. I hope you are still praying. We want to pray because you see, this time, you see, everybody is afraid. Fear is around. And when there is fear, satanic oppression increases. You are going to pray like this. That any dark power using this period to fight me, you are a liar. Die! Open your mouth and pray that. Any power using this period to fight you, oh yeah, they are liars. Let them die. Let them die. Let them begin to 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 die. Hey, Maro Shete Yadia. Hey, the Mapano Shete Yadia. Hey, the Mababo Shete Yada Babo Shete Yada. Hey, the No Masatania. Hey, the Babadosh. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. We are children of authority. You can see how one infirmity is shutting down government, shutting down economy. You have the authority to shut down some powers. I want you to say this loud and clear. Satanic activities against my life, I shut you down. Those of you having bad dreams, you don't understand why the bad dream persists. But I want you to begin to say it, that you shut down activities of darkness around you, in your home, against your health. Shut it down. Are you ready now? You say it loud and clear. Satanic activities! Can I hear you louder? Let's go! Around my life, against my life, I shut you down. I shut you down. I shut you down. I shut you down. Begin to shut down every decision of witches and wizards. Shut it down. It cannot catch up with you. Shut it down. 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 Oh, begin to shut it down. Shut down those activities. Beloved, this is not the time now to pray. You should be praying now. Shut it down. Shut it down. Every activities of witches and wizards, let them be shut down. 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 Let these activities be shut down. Let them be shut down. Satanic activities around me, be shut down. Be shut down. Be shut down. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. I use this period to pray for you. Anyone going through witchcraft attack during this period, you have been having strange dreams. I decree, let every witchcraft attack, witchcraft activities launch against your peace, let them be shut down in the name of Jesus. Let them be shut down in the name of Jesus. Let them be shut down in the name of Jesus. Somebody there, you had an attack of a snake bite. That poison has been squeezed off your leg right now in the name of Jesus. And the power of the Lord is upon somebody there. Three strange women joined hand together to curse you overnight. I order the power of that curse right now to be broken in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Blessed be your holy name. Daddy, speak to us today. Let your name alone be glorified. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. God bless you. Sit down. Take your Bible. Don't forget, this is the time to... This is the time to sit down and hear the word of God. At this point in time, we should know that this situation is serious. Some of us don't believe it's serious. This infirmity called coronavirus is killing people. I'm telling you, you have to know that it's serious. I believe that some of us have ignored the truth. You know, some people have this way of ignoring the truth. Having the mind that, oh, it's not for me, Jerry. What is happening? People are dying. I could hear one of the governors, I think that of New York, asking for 45,000 ventilators. People are under those things. People are using it. Beds, more beds. People are taking that bed. But I prophesy into your life. You are hearing that they are buying more. I prophesy into your life that none of you will go under those ventilators in the name of Jesus. You are hearing that every country, they are acquiring beds. I'm telling you, there are some people that will go on that bed. It's a serious situation. I prophesy. You are not going to get any of those beds in the name of Jesus. Your name will not be attached to any sick bed in the name of Jesus. People are dying, beloved. Economies are being shut down. The economy of countries are being shut down. This period is real. It is real. So at this period, what do? We turn to the Bible. There is nothing that is strange to the Bible. That's why I like the Bible. What did I say? There is nothing that is strange to the Bible. Nothing strange. There is nothing that is happening now that you can't find a root to it in the Bible. That is why the Bible is a place where we should not ignore right now. I've been saying this right from last Sunday, that families should pray together. You should seek time to pray. Some people have yielded and they can see some changes. Because let me tell you something that will happen. For this spirit, this strange pestilence to go, it requires the move of God. And you see, when that move comes, people that have been in captivity for years, captivities that has nothing to do with any infirmity or anything, but you are labored for it, you are labored under it for years. With this move, a lot of captivities will also what? Break. So utilize this period. God is dropping mantle of power this period. God is empowering us people this period. So that is why I want you, beyond everything, utilize this period. This is the time to be focused. This is the time to throw away every distraction. This is the time that we need to move close to God. We need to move close to God. I remember those days in the choir, we used to sing a Negro spiritual. I love that song. It just kept coming to my heart all night. If you ever needed the Lord before, we surely need him now. We surely need him now. We surely need him now. If you ever needed the Lord before, we surely need him now. We need him every day and every hour. If we ever needed the Lord before, we surely need him now. We surely need him now. We surely need him now. If we ever needed the Lord before, we surely need him now. We need him every day and every hour. This period is the period we need God. So for those of you that are still using that method of ignoring God, wanting to do it your own way, you'll be wasted. The only security we have right now, we can see that the doctors cannot help you. What are those ventilators doing to relieve you of your pain? No cure. The only cure we have is Jesus. And I've seen people that have looked unto him and they have been delivered. I'm telling you, I have people that personally have called me that have this infirmity and they prayed and they're out. They prayed and they're out. It's the only way out right now is to be a friend of God. This evil is something that is out. Those people that will be spared are people that have this relationship with God. That is what leads me to what we're about to discuss now. Very briefly, we'll discuss it and we will pray. What is it called? Destroying the fiery serpent. How to what? Destroy the fiery serpent. As I told you, everything that is happening now is something that has been experienced in the Bible before. Something that has been experienced in the Bible before. Let's look at the Bible. Let's turn to the book of Numbers. Numbers 21, verse 5. I want you to understand what is going on right now. If you can understand it, a lot of us, this is not the time to start pointing fingers. I want you to look at yourself right now. Numbers 21, verse 5 to 9. He said, and the people speak against God and against Moses. Wherefore have ye brought us up out of Egypt to die in the wilderness? For there is no bread, neither there any water, and our soul loathed this light bread. Can you hear that? They spoke against the Lord. If you look at what has been going on around our society right now, you see that people have decided to stand up against God. People don't even know that no matter what you do, no matter the politics you play, whatsoever God has confirmed, that is what will come to pass. Laws are being enacted against the will of God. A country called God's own country is working desperately to pull God out of the country. Everything is accepted apart from what has God inside. That is what we have been saying. People have come against God. People have spoken against God, even Christians. Because our relationship, you see, we have gotten to a level right now that the church is filled with people that the only reason they are coming to church is because they have problems, not because they love the Lord. The only reason they are serving the Lord is because they have problems. Some people, the reason they are still working so hard is because God has not answered them. Once God answers them, they will give God condition. They will speak against the Lord. That is the condition of the Israelite that time. After eating manna, after experiencing the Red Sea, come up, just like some of us have experienced serious hand of God. The move of the hand of God, you have experienced so many. But yet, we still speak against the Lord. We still say it. I look at some people saying that, I don't know what this God is doing. Oh! These men, their offense was that they spoke against the Lord. In this generation, we are not just speaking against the Lord. Governments are rising up against the Lord. Everything that has God inside is being pulled aside. That's why people don't want to hear anything about God. I remember this last week, the president of America was speaking, and immediately he mentioned by Easter, the church will be filled. You see a lot of people came up, analysts coming up on various networks speaking. And I know the reason for that drive is that church he mentioned. But as they started talking, analysts said, it cannot be possible. I remember those networks, again, they are those networks gathered, the analysts confirmed that this man cannot be president, and he became president. So we discovered that in our society, anything that has to do with God, there is contention. That was what was happening at that period. They stood against God. They stood against his servant. They wanted their way. Free. Everything is free. Free to do anything. I can do anything I want. No law. Nothing. That was what they wanted. They forgot all those wonders that the Lord has done. Just like some of us are doing. There are people watching me right now that they from if you can be so, if you can just allow your mind to reflect where God has brought you from, you will know that you owe the Lord a lot. Some of you, where God has taken you from. Some people have been, you have experienced accident that people never knew you would come out. But you came out without a scratch. But now, we have turned against the Lord. There are people that say, oh, I'm not coming to church again. I want to do my life. I want to live my life. If God wants to help, you could see it now. You can only do that in a society where you are comfortable. You could see. They turned against the Lord. But what happened to them? Let's quickly look at what happened in verse 6. And the Lord sent fiery serpent. Who sent fiery serpent? God. So some of us that normally say, oh, God is not that wicked. God is, yes, he's a merciful God. But yet, in some ways, he's terrible. You could see his people. He said, the Lord sent fiery serpents among the people. And they beat the people and much people of Israel. Can you hear that? Of Israel died. People died. People that God spent time to save. They died. Why? They came against the Lord. Some of us that anytime people say, this is wrong. He said, I can live my life anyway. You are standing against the Lord. The fiery serpent is out now to bite. And I'm telling you, the fiery serpent is biting. People have been beaten. You that you come to church, you don't listen. When the word of God is going, you are busy on social media, posting, reading posts. The fiery serpent is out there biting. People looking at me, you find it hard this time that you are even at home to spend time with the Lord. I'm telling you, the fiery serpent is how to bite. And it's biting. That is the truth. Don't let us neglect. Some of us, we are neglecting it. It's happening. People are dying. They are dying. The rich people are dying in Europe right now. They have to, they don't think, it will not be possible to have personal graves. Because look at it, where can you have a personal grave to bury 10,000 people? And it's happening, it's still going on. The fiery serpent is out. Because the whole world came against this God. They came against this world. Do you think it's coincidental when laws were passed against the Lord in New York? And things started moving there. Louisiana went out with this terrible festival to celebrate the spirit of lust. And this serpent is operating with fury. Beloved, this has happened in the Bible before. The fury serpent is out. Those of you that don't want to build yourself spiritually, say, build yourself, be spiritual. You say, no, when I have money, I'll be spiritual. You will never get the money. It's not a curse. you will never. So we, when I get married, I will be spiritual. Now I have to use all I have, everything to secure husband, everything I have to secure a wife. So anything I can break the law, I can do anything to the fury serpent is out there. Oh, forgive. Say, I will never forgive. I will never forgive. God, we have to fight for me before I will forgive. If I see God fight and the person is under pain, that's when I will forgive. The fury serpent is out. Say, live in peace as a family. Say, no, no. You do everything to make sure there is no peace in your home. The fury serpent is out. It's out. No matter. The car you ride, wind up, put AC on. The fury serpent is still out and is biting people, biting people, biting people. Why? They came against the Lord. They spoke against the Lord. Let's go on. Verse 7. Therefore, the people came to Moses. That is the step we are supposed to do right now. Therefore, the people came to Moses and said, we have what? Sinned. That is what we should be praying for, the spirit of conviction to move upon the earth. You could see what happened in Italy and how the president broke down. To say, the only thing that can help us now is God. That is the level the Lord wants. So that is why we need conviction. The spirit of conviction to move, and people will begin to have that fear of God before. Conviction that will make people to be afraid to say, I'm not a Christian. Conviction that will make people say, I have to do everything to make heaven. Conviction that will make people stand against evil with all their heart. That was what happened here. I said, they came and they said, we have sinned. That is why, you see, you could hear Father in the Lord, Dr. D.K. Olukoya, telling us, this is the time to examine ourselves. This is the time for us to sit down and look at it. You can deceive everybody, but you can't deceive God. Some of us, our mind has been in bad state. Some of us, our mind, if it's open, is like a dirty canal. And you go around with it and they say, where are the Christians? You raise up your hand. A time of reflection. They came to Moses and said, we have sinned. For we have spoken against the Lord and against thee. Pray unto the Lord that he taketh away the serpent from us. Can you see? We need to turn to God. It's God that can take away what? Coronavirus. It's God, I'm telling you. It's God. Look at what science are saying. They said it will take 12 months to have a vaccine. That's if they even find 12. What will happen in 12 months if people are dying at this rate? We need God to take away the fury serpent. And that was what the people of Israel realized when people have died. I don't know where you are connecting to me from, but I just want to tell you that it's time to repent. This is the time for us to repent. That's why, as Christians, those of you that are Christians shaking your head, we need to do a lot of things to reach out to people. This period, you go on Instagram just looking for what to make you laugh. Start posting things that will convict people. Start using that platform to reach out to souls. And you see, as we launch that out, the spirit of conviction will be released. And people will realize the churches are not interested in sinners again. A lot of men of God are sitting now and say, yes, I am a supreme man of God. One of them, I was watching the social media, I was saying, coronavirus cannot come here because I have a corrosive anointing. Huh? It will swallow you and your corrosive anointing. You are not supposed to be boasting. You are supposed to be boasting that you have a God that can do all things. Not an anointing. Your anointing that cannot prevent it. You want the anointing. They say, I corrosive. Let it come. Let it come. You are in your house. You're saying, let it come. Travel. Come to China. Say, let it come. What is happening in churches right now is that we are recycling members. Somebody will leave this church, say, I don't like the way the pastor is talking. The way the pastor look at me, I don't like. You move to another church. And the person there is rejoicing. Members are coming. No. In heaven, we are just recycling goats from one church. Another goat has moved to your place. That same goat you have acquired, we eat you one day with horn. Then we run away to another place. But we are not getting new sheep. We are not getting people that say, I was not going to church before, but somebody ministered to me and I gave my life to Christ. Those are the testimonies that God is expecting right now. Not from somebody, I have been to 12 prophets. They have laid hands on me. Now I am free. You see, most of them, once they are free, you won't see them in church again. They are back. Those are not testimonies. This period is the period where all of you, no, don't say I'm not a pastor. Start reaching out to people. Start talking to unbelievers. Start showing them love. Start, because this period we are right now is a crucial period. People will keep dying until the Lord takes away the Sabbath. The Israelites realize fast. And that's why when we say pray, some people don't know why we are praying. And when you say, I'm enjoying being at home. Very soon you'll be broke. It's not a curse. So being at home is not a good thing. We must what? Pray. Oh, some people say, I'm rejoicing. The federal government said, no, nobody should evict anybody. Once everything is over, you will still pay those bills. They are waiting for you. This is the period for you to really look unto God. And let us pray. It's time to reach out. Look at what happened. How did this fury serpent disappear? How did they get rid of this fury serpent? Verse 8. And the Lord said unto Moses, make thee a fury serpent and set it upon a pole, and it shall come to pass that everyone that is beaten, when it looketh upon it, shall live. Can you see the solution? We say, Pastor, what are you saying? What type of solution? Should we go get serpents and put it in front of you? But if you're a good Bible reader, you will know the depth of this serpent that is being raising up, and people should live. What? Look. And they will live. Let's look at what the Bible says in John 3. John 3. Verse 14. It's Jesus talking now. He said, and as Moses lifted up the serpent in the wilderness, even so must the Son of Man be lifted up. So what is the way to get rid of this fury serpent killing people? Is for Jesus to be what? Exalted. And when we do that exalting, when we do the work, is it just the pastors? Everybody, Christians. Make sure that this is not the time to be too afraid to tell people you are a Christian. Exalt his name. Let people know more about Jesus. The more people look to him, this will pass away. That is the solution. To put an end to this fury serpent. Looking up to Jesus, the author and the finisher of it. People will say, Pastor, what are you? It's so easy to say that. How many of you are looking unto Jesus? You open. A lot of us, we are not looking unto Jesus. A lot of us, we have taken our eyes off Jesus. A lot of Christians, your eyes is on your problem. A lot of people, your eyes is on your financial life. I can do anything to make money. As long as I make money, I can do anything. You have taken your eyes off Jesus. You cannot even come to the house of the Lord. Talk less of paying tithe. There are some people that are earning money right now, but they are not paying tithe. You ask them, I can't pay tithe. We don't know how the thing is going. We have to save every money we have. Oh my God. your face is not on Jesus. Because if your face is there, you know that you do. This is even the time more to give more to the Lord. Because we need him. Just like the song I sang earlier. More than any time, we need him now. You need to move close. This is not the time to cut yourself off. There are some people now, they're not watching. They have walked out. They're not watching. And very soon, if anything, if cough, they will say, Pastor, hey, this cough is coming. You know, this period, we pastors are getting serious calls. Cough, running nose. I said, take vitamin C. I'm even a doctor now. I say, take this. You have to do this. Take ginger. Say, the way I'm coughing. The way. It was 80 degrees the other time. And a lot of people, you know that your body will be hot. So people will say, my temperature. Don't wait until the serpent bites before you look. If you can look now, the serpent will not bite. Start looking. Stop living this life of I don't care. Stop living this life that you have taken God. A lot of us, we want to make decisions. God is out. Out. You are getting a job and you are getting the job. You know this job will take you out of Christ. And you are still taking it. You say, your eyes is off. The serpent that will help. Jesus. All eyes. The way out of this Buha that we have found ourselves now is to look unto Jesus. Where are you putting your trust? Are you putting some people? Their trust is, my husband, that's your trust. Your trust, your face is not on Jesus, it's not your husband. That husband will disappoint you. We say, my wife, that wife will disappoint you. We say, my children, anything for my children. God, later, my children, those children will, but God will never disappoint you. So the way out of this period is for us to look unto Jesus, exalt him in every way you can find. In your home, raise up an altar of praise. This is the time to teach your children how to sing by fire, by force. Raise altar of praise. If the family is so blessed that nobody has voice, go to YouTube, be playing. At least you can dance. They can't take away voice and dance from you. You must have one. Go there and begin to raise praises, altar of praise. Praise the Lord. Be with him. Exalt him in your home, in your life. Is there anything you are doing right now that is not of God? You need to drop it. Everything must be focused on him. And if you are listening to me, you say, I want to serve the Lord, but I can't live this life. I want to do the two. You can't do the two. You have to take one. I know there are a lot of people, they can get, when it's time to get drunk, you can get drunk. When it's time to prophesy, you will prophesy too. When it's time to go to party, you can do it. No, you are deceiving yourself. You have to take one. You have to take one. It comes with a price. I put it to you today that this is the time for us to exalt the Son of God. And that was the end of the plague. The Bible says, once they look, they live. You want to survive this period? You think it's only hand sanitizer that you need? You need the Son of God. I was listening to someone that said, she said she's a nurse. She used everything, but she still got it. She still got it. So what you need right now, beyond the hand sanitizer, beyond face mask, you see people going with the mask with confidence. You know, when you have the mask, you walk with confidence. When you don't have, you are walking somehow. When they walk, you can put on the mask. And people are still being hit with it. The only way out is to look at the Son of God. I put it to you as Christians in your home now. Are you looking at him? Being raised up right now. Look at Jesus. Let your life, let there be a reset button that will take you back to your first love. Those times you were with God that you would not do anything except you have first taken it to the Lord in prayer. Go back to that. Go back to that period that when God puts something on your heart, you do it. Not that you give God 10 excuses why you should not do it. Some of us, we have allowed the lust of our heart to take the place of God. I'm telling you, self-isolation, all those things, they are good. But there are people that have gone through it and the serpent still what? Bite them. The way out is to look unto Jesus. Exalt the name of Jesus again. Make him your all in all. Surrender to him. Spend time with him. And this period will pass over. And when we are counting, you will be among those people that will be counted in the name of Jesus. Let's rise up on our feet right now. All eyes closed now. And I want to begin to look unto Jesus and tell him that, God, have mercy. In any way, I have taken my eyes off you. Some people, they will even tell you they have reason that God has not answered me, so I have to help myself. Huh? And we read this Bible. Can't you see people like Abraham? He was seeing God, and yet his prayer was not answered. He still entertained him. Those men and women are humans like us. So you don't have any reason to talk against him. So those of you that your mouth has been running against God, you don't have any reason. So surrender to him today and say, Lord, have mercy. In any way I've put my eyes off, forgive me in the name of Jesus. The Son of God is lifted high. The Son of God is lifted high. I want everywhere, wherever you are, I want that voice to come out. The Son of God is lifted high. The Son of God is lifted high. Oh, Emmanuel is lifted high.
Emmanuel is lifted high.
Oh, wonderful and glorious. Oh, Jesus, the Son of God is lifted. What? The Son of God is lifted. I, oh.
The Son of God is lifted. I,
oh, the Son of God is lifted. I, oh.
The Son of God is lifted.
Oh, oh, oh. Jesus, and the Son of God is lifted. Oh, the Son of God is lifted. Oh, yeah, oh,
the Son of God.
Oh, let the whole heart. Oh, the Son of God is lifted.
The Son of God is lifted.
Oh,
wonderful and glorious.
Oh,
yeah. The Son.
to sing it.
Oh, the Son of God has lifted up.
The Son of God is lifted up.
Oh, Emmanuel has lifted up.
The Son of God is lifted up.
Somebody sing it.
That's the solution. Let's lift him up.
Oh, the Son of God has lifted
us. The Son of
God. Oh, he's lifted
us.
Oh, the Son of God has lifted
us. The Son of God.
Over the whole world. And glorious, oh yeah. Let the whole earth lift up the name of Jesus. Oh, the Son of God is lifted up. In your home, lift up his name. Yeah, Emmanuel is lifted. Oh, the Son of God has lifted us.
The Son of God.
Hey, let your home say it. The Son of God is lifted
us. The Son of God is lifted
us. Oh, 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 oh.
Yeah. Wonderful and glorious.
Oh. Sleep tada. Oh Lord, let your love be restored in our heart today.
The Son of God is lifted up.
Oh, let souls begin to test for more of Jesus today.
The Son of God is
oh, in our various homes, we'll lift Jesus up. Let every home sing it. Wherever coronavirus has entered, we'll lift the name of Jesus up.
Let every heart hearing me experience revival. Let your antenna to tune to heaven be resonant. Let your spirit move into our homes today by fire. Those of you that have heard this sermon and you have decided to let him use you, I want you to use you to reach out to souls. Just raise up your hand right now. It's going to anoint you for it specially. Some of us will say, oh, I'm not an evangelist. At this point, it's a commission for everybody. Just raise up your right hand there. And let's lift up that name again. The Son of God is lifted up.
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 Let's go. Let your spirit come now. Let the spirit of the living God come upon these people now. Let the spirit of the living God come in. Let the spirit of prayer come in. Let the spirit of revival come in. Shut the curtain. Yes, you have been lighting up. Let us shed
down.
Receive the boldness to speak about Christ. Yes. Oh, yeah. Oh. The Son of God. Thank you, Lord Jesus. We ask for mercy as a church today. That Lord would lift you high. We don't want to see any man. This generation has celebrated men too much. Men has taken the place of God. Daddy, we lift you high. Immune us and our families. We lift you high today. This pestilence must not enter our homes. We lift you high today. We order coronavirus to flee from our cities, from our counties, and let the name of Jesus be exalted. Oh, 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 we are wonderful and glorious. Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Amen.
Pray. praise the name of the Lord. It's time for offering now and tithe. Some of you don't know the reason why you have to give now. You need to give so that you can be protected. You need to give to show God that, Lord, I am on the Lord's side. Then I must be protected. I pray for you that you will not have to use your own money on infirmity. I know there will be a lot of people that will not give, that will keep. But we see, when you give, you are securing your home. You are putting a number that, God, I pay my tithe. I must not spend my own money on infirmity. Else, let's look at what is going on. There is a limit that the insurance company will help when it gets to a level. It's time to give. And I want you to look at, take your wallet now. Take time. We will give you enough time. We will praise the Lord. Before we round up, please don't forget to share this video. Know how to share it. Share the video and make sure that you click on the notification bell. Subscribe and click on so that you can get notification. So it's time to give right now. Bindia will put on the videos. If you want to use Zelle, look at how you do it. PayPal, that's the way. Money app, Cash app, that's the next one they dignify. Use any of them. As you worship the Lord, give him praises, exalt his name. We do that. Let's pray on the offering. Father, we thank you for this offering and tithe. We pray, Lord, that you will bless your children. You will enlarge their coast. You do that which only you can do. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. It's time we're giving, worshiping the Lord, lifting up that name Jesus in our homes. Please, let's put that thing back on so that people that are watching. Yes, let's lift up the name of Jesus and give him adoration as we worship him.